Like, let's say you didn't know how to say I don't know in Spanish. Yo no sé. Let's say you didn't know that, right? You could tell by how Luis says I don't know that he's saying I don't know. Mira. Hey Luis, where'd you put that stack of books by Osho? Hello everyone, it's me Chloe. Welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are doing really, really well. I just came back with my coffee. See, I already know how to put the webcam on. You already know I got some crazy shit to say. You already know it's gonna be a good video. Ya to sabe das it. So. Oh my gosh, you guys, my place is a huge disorganized mess right now. And I don't know, I kind of like it like that. Like, I do enjoy when after I've cleaned to sit in the beautiful sanctity of my clean home. But sometimes you guys ever just feel like, yeah, that's my home. Yeah, I threw that piece of paper. Yeah, I threw that hair clip. You know what I mean? Like, you pay the rent, you throw the hair clip, and that's it. Because, you know, you gotta, like, there's some joy in being the queen or the king of your castle. I call it, I say to myself that I'm the queen of my frequency portal. And sometimes that means you gotta throw some shit. You know, I don't break nothing. I make sure that when I'm in that mood, that everything is kept nice and safe, because I do like my stuff too. So, okay. I had a couple of observations this week that I figured I would save up until there were enough to hit you guys with, like, maybe like 10, 13 full minutes. So, okay. So I work in a store with people that whose first language is Spanish. And I'm yo soy latina en mi corazón. Yo soy de un barrio dominicano. I'm like Latin in my soul. I'm from a Dominican neighborhood. Like, I'm a Washington Heights. So I am, like, culturally, I'm not Latina culturally, but I understand. I've been grown up in, you know, around the Latina culture my whole life. So Miami, when I came here on vacation, made a lot of sense to me. It's beautiful. Everywhere I turn, it looks like a painting. The people feel like they have, like, the essence of New York, but they have their own, like, Miami vibe going on too. So I love it here, and the culture makes sense to me and everything like that. It's funny because I could go, like, I'm from New York City, so I could go like 20 minutes upstate where there's no Latinos, no Spanish people, and I feel less at home than coming like 1500 miles south to Miami, ¿me entiendes? So anyway, the store where I work, they're at the store. Everybody speaks Spanish, and actually they only hire people that speak Spanish, so I passed the test by a hair. And I've been working there for a while, and I love it there. I love my coworkers. You guys know who you are. Oh my god, today's my day off, and like, for like 1 second when I just said I love my coworkers, I actually missed doing price outs and inventory. That's a lot of love right there. So anyways, but sometimes I deadass do not understand what my coworkers are saying, because they speak really fast. I grew up in my home speaking English. My mother speaks Yiddish. My mother hasn't spoken Yiddish fluently since her grandmother died, so we only speak English from my house, right? So even though I do speak Spanish, when my coworkers are speaking really fast, I'm totally lost. And I realized though, like, if you pay attention to their body, my coworkers' body language, or and facial expressions and gestures, even if you don't know, even if I don't know, like, the actual words, like what they're saying, I can totally decipher the meaning through their gestures. And something that I notice is, like, when, and my like, most of them are Boricua, they're Puerto Rican. So, like, I have this one coworker, let's just call him, what are we, Luis, okay, Luis. when Luis is saying, I don't know, like, let's say you didn't know how to say, I don't know in Spanish, yo no sé, let's say you didn't know that, right? You could tell by how Luis says, I don't know, that he's saying, I don't know. Mira. Hey Luis, where'd you put that stack of books by Osho?
I didn't see it. Don't say.
Hey Luis, do you know where the pricing gun is?
I didn't put it, yo no sé. I don't know. Like that, I don't know.
He's always like, when his eyes bulge and he looks down, that's I don't know. That, and I don't know, like, the more indignant the I don't know, the more, like, the more intense the expression gets. So, like, where's the pricing gun?
Yo no sé.
Okay, pero, like, if you're asking, who would do something like that? Like, who would act like that? Who would behave like that? You're talking about, like, somebody or whatever. Like, who acts like this? And he goes, like that. Like, then it gets, like, more intense because it's, like, about values and life and shit. dude, Luis, you crack me up. You don't even know. So Luis cracks me up. And then I have a coworker, ella es cubana, she's Cuban, and she's from here, she's from Miami, so she's kind of like, it's weird because she's kind of exactly like me. She has long red hair and blue eyes, and we're the same height and, like, the same weight, and that's a little weird. She's like a go-between. We're very similar. She's more like chill than I am, but she goes between, like, being completely, like, having just a, being a totally, like, American girl to being Latina, and, like, there's no segue. It's seamless transition. So she's like, hey man, like, she's totally like, hey man, out. She's such a chill, cool girl. I just think, like, her ability to, like, do that, to go between being like, hey man, what's going on, dude, and, like, having that, like, that vibe, and then the Latina vibe is just, like, it's cool, it's weird how similar her and I are. Pero yo, I love that, I love it. My other coworker, he's so, let's call him Franco es like that. Franco, he's so gentle and sweet. I always, like, whenever we have the time, Franco and I have the time to talk, he always, like, gives me, like really sweet, positive affirmations about life. He tells me, ay, little mommy, no te preocupes, don't worry about nothing, because you only have this moment, and the past is, the future is only your imagination. He's so, like, he has this, like, beautiful mind, this beautiful spirit, and, like, he goes, like, because I bring a lot of my artwork to work to show my coworkers. A lot of my coworkers, like, they'll buy my artwork. They just really, we all have, like, a really good rapport. So he'll look at my work, like, if I bring a shell or something. Like this one, he says, dígame. He go, dígame. I love it. He's just so, like, emphatic when he loves something. I love it. With his little, like, cute, sweet gesture. His little, goes like that. He's such a beautiful person. Pero yeah. Okay, but I actually, even though I don't have to be at the job today, I still have work to do because as you all know, I am an artiste. This is my dad. My dad is a singer. You guys should check out his channel, Henry Ray. I want to put a link below. But that's my papa. He's singing with his bandmates. That's his... There you go. That's one of his best friends in the whole world, who's a pianist. And then, I'm not sure of this guy's name, but I hear him on my dad's tracks all the time. He's awesome. I love this painting as it is. You know, like, I'm a perfectionist, you guys. And the fact it looks really scratchy and weird actually doesn't bother me. Oh my god, I love this painting. I think I'm just gonna like it like that. Pero yeah, I love it. And I love you all. If I don't post a video for like 7 days, know that one is coming. I am just accruing more and more inspiration for you guys, so that we have more and more fun with each video. I'd like you guys off to work. Oh, not off to work. I'm not going off, but back to work for me right now. Take care. See you soon. Bye.